cycling into Berlin. It was snowing, it was actually the first snow we got, and me and Ulrich were just cycling right next to each other and talking to each other. Ulrich's bike slipped, and in spectacular form, he fell, and I was right next to him, and I fell over him, and there we go, just sliding over the pavement. And that was our introduction into the snow. So yeah, really, really interesting, classic entry into Berlin. Yeah, it was really, really funny. We had a good fall. It's been raining, snowing, it's been under minus 20 degrees. Some of the coldest nights, and some of the days were, yeah, between minus 10 and minus 16 degrees. So yeah, it's been really cold and had a lot of rain, especially in England, Montenegro.
It's goat. It's genuine goat.
Hey, Jochen.
Don't really have any gears at the moment. It's just freezing up, so can't use the shifter. So yeah, that's a little bit of a problem. I couldn't see it until I let go. Our camping spot for tonight. It's lovely in the ice cold winter in Europe. And yeah, it's about minus 10 at the moment. My world starts to turn. And I'll taste every moment and live it out loud. I know this is the time. This is the time to be.
That's about the speed. I've been going today.
Yeah, it's been a good day. A lot of hills actually. Quite tough, but yeah, enjoy to get the hills again a bit. So
can you hear us?
I know. First I'm gonna eat two oranges and then just get a bit of vitamin C in my body, and yeah, I'm gonna read a bit to my tent, do my journal, and yeah, see you after that.
Rain. Yeah, I had a lot of rain in Europe, as you can expect, of course, in Europe. There's always some kind of part that you'll always get a lot of rain, like England, of course. You always get a lot of rain in England.
I pulled over. It's not late, I think it's about 2 o'clock. But yeah, it's not stopped raining for the last 4 hours.
In Montenegro, just had a lot of rain. The rain came down and was just like... was pools and pools and pools of water. There were roads flooding, and yeah, but that was just after my Croatia trip, and I just decided I'm going for it. I have to get back on the road, and yeah, it wasn't the perfect entry to start again, but yeah, it's really good.
I put on my poncho, my jacket underneath my poncho, so the poncho doesn't work anymore, the jacket doesn't work anymore, nothing more. So I'm just so fed up at the moment with this clothing thing and the rain.
So I'm in my tent and mostly dry. Luckily my warm jacket is still dry, so makes it a lot better. Just came up this little hill. See, not
pretty going straight.
Like a whiteout, so couldn't see anything. Just climbing. And I think there was supposed to be a few good views, but yeah, didn't see any. Couldn't see any. Just off 9 o'clock, and still on the snow. Very, very tough. Second day in a row now.
If it's just cycling on the snow, it's something totally different than when it's been snowing and lying there for about a few weeks and actually getting hard, because then it's getting slippery and you really have to concentrate. It's just like that, and you just fall down. So the last cycling the snow was something to get used to, but that's one of the reasons I chose to cycle through Europe in the winters, to get used to those conditions. To get used to those conditions for things to come in the future, of course. That's going to be really interesting. So at some point the cheese was frozen, the ham was frozen, the water we carried was frozen. It was really, really something interesting and something to get used to.
That's the water bottle.
Yeah.
Solidly frozen.
No, do it against your head.
I'm not stupid.
Or when the wind picks up. So that chill factor is always something to consider. It can be minus 5 days are much cooler than minus 16 days if the wind blows. It's some of the toughest times and the most frustrating times. At that very point, but it's that moment that you actually remember afterwards. So
it's opening up so you can actually see. It's quite beautiful, but very hot.
At the moment, the about -5 degrees. So yeah, I have no idea at the moment, but that's not the thing. The problem at the moment is this road that actually looks very cycle. Looks very nice. Look at the back. Now the problem is everything locked up. I can't even push the bicycle. Camping in minus 20 degrees snow and rain. it was something to get used to, but really enjoyed it. On a bicycle you really go out and you see the small things. Meet the people, smell the air, and you can feel the nature, see the nature, talk to the people if they can speak any English. Always some kind of way you can communicate. And that's what makes traveling on a bicycle so great. And the people all around, they've been great. There's always somebody that wants to help, even if it's accommodation or food or just some help, how to get to a supermarket or a route out of a city or water or food or whatever it is. There's always in every country there's been somebody that wants to help, and that's just such a great experience. And that's the kind of things I really, 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 really love.
is getting to know some of the people on the way and meeting those cultures. I'm about to start my third continent. I cannot hardly believe it. Yeah, the biggest continent, Asia. So yeah, it will take me about 12,000 kilometers, between 12 and 15,000 kilometers. I'll try to do a few more, or do more videos, or do a video blog just once in a while, just showing you around what's happening or where I am, even if it's just a short 1 to 2 minutes. So yeah, enjoy it. There's great things that's going to come in the next few months and the next year. So yeah, please keep following, and I'll chat to you soon.